that'll make us feel good. That's what you have nowadays, man. Where the real war is at, man? We out here calling warriors, man. You guys in space, guess what? God made you to be the kings and queens of this earth, but you're not acting like it, man. You want to gangbang on your own people all day. You want to hate the next so-called black and Hispanic man all day, but when a European comes down your block, you're all, hey, how you doing, sir? What's going on, sir? You blacks and Hispanics still have the slave mentality on you, man. And we trying to break that chain, you know why? Because it's hard time to wake up and speak like the Bible says, man. Read that real quick, all
right? Isaiah 5 and 13. Therefore, my people are gone into captivity.
The Bible says my people have gone into captivity. You know who's God's chosen people, brothers and sisters? According to the Bible, you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you're God's chosen people. What did the Lord say?
Therefore, my people are gone into captivity.
The Bible says, God says, you blacks and Hispanics have gone into captivity. Why?
Because they have no knowledge.
Because you have no knowledge. You think this million man march is going to set you free. But guess what? Every one of you is walking back home with no solution to your problem.
Right.
Yeah. All of you is walking back home with no solution how to make more money to feed your kids the next day.
That's right.
All you're going to do is go back and slave a 9-to-5 to the so-called white man the next day and not give a damn about your own people, man. That's all this is set up for, man. You think the white man don't use them tactics on you blacks and Hispanics, man? The white man knows you blacks and Hispanics ain't going to fight back. That's why he uses you, man. That's why he gives you a million man march so you can be brainwashed to believe he's doing something for you when he's doing the opposite. So read that again, right?
Therefore, my people are gone into captivity.
The Bible says God's chosen people are gone into captivity. When you look at this world, who are the only two nations catching hell and its captives in America besides the so-called blacks and Hispanics? All right? You blacks and Hispanics, you make up America. Why are you not benefiting of what you make of? Why are you creating buildings for the so-called white man, but you can't bother me? Why are you creating mansions for the so-called white man, but you get a little goddamn apartment or a studio for $700, $800 a month, man?
Right.
Robbing you. $1,300 if you live in New York. Okay? So guess what? The white man is robbing you blind, but you blacks and Hispanics, you've been deceived, man. You've been deceived by religion. You've been deceived by vain, man-made philosophies, right? Everybody could get together, everybody's equal. Where in the Bible does it say everybody's equal, man? The Bible says you Israelites who are so-called blacks and Hispanics are above all people that are upon the face of this earth, man. Where's that equality in the Bible? You can't find that. You know why? The white man wants you to be inferior to him because he knows he's inferior to you.
Hey.
Okay? The so-called white man is the devil that the Bible speaks of,
that's
and you
know
everybody 24/7 whether you like it or not.
Right.
Whether you want to be an Uncle Tom or Coon or set up and kick the white man's ass, guess what? We are here for you blacks and Hispanics to wake up, man.
Right.
Read that out.
Therefore, my people are gone into captivity.
You hear that, blacks and Hispanics? The Bible says you have gone to captivity. What can you teach your children about slavery? Why did you go into slavery, brother? Why? Let's not wear a suit and tie to play the white man's game like it's all good. Let's be real with our children, man. Why did we go in captivity, blacks and Hispanics? Because we broke God's laws, statutes, and commandments, man. And you can laugh all day, but guess what? When World War III comes, and martial law comes, and the white man comes gunning you down for the Russian troops, you ain't gonna do laugh at them, man. So we out here trying to warn you of what we're getting into, man. We're getting into World War III as we speak right now. Do you know that the Russian troops already bombed Syria to try to bomb the U.S. to start World War III in Syria? Do you know that Bible prophecy, blacks and Hispanics? That's Bible prophecy, man. If you blacks and Hispanics, you don't speak to them. You don't watch, you don't watch the news. You don't watch Love and Hip Hop all day. You don't watch the BET channel all day. You don't watch the MTV channel all day. Nothing that has to do with your slavery, you don't want to study about, man. But guess what? Reality shows you blacks and Hispanics love and show the truth of who you are. Because guess what? The slave master named us African American. The slave master named us Hispanics, Native Americans. What were we before the slave master names, man? What were we calling ourselves, man? Because you blacks and Hispanics weren't speaking English before you got conquered. You blacks and Hispanics weren't speaking Spanish before you got conquered. So what is Farrakhan giving you, man? What kind of knowledge is Farrakhan giving you according to who you are, man? You know what he's doing? Getting into the white man's trap. Okay, march all day, but ain't no solution to your goddamn problems, man. And that's the problem with so-called blacks and Hispanics, man. You don't want no solution to your problem, man. Every time the prophets of God is out here giving you the solution, you're going to turn away and want to hear something that make you feel good. But guess what? We're not out here to make you feel good. We're out here to tell you the judgment, son. Thus saith the Lord.
All right. Right.
So read that.
Therefore, my people are going into captivity.
The Bible says you blacks and Hispanics have gone into captivity. Come on.
Because they have no knowledge.
Because you have no knowledge. Like I said, if you ask blacks and Hispanics, what's your nationality right now, you get 20, 30 different answers, man. How is a so-called black man giving 10, 20 different answers on their nationality? How is a so-called Hispanic giving 10, 20 different
answers? Polite did what? What did Polite do? What did Polite do?
Did you see that? Did you see what Polite?
What did Polite do?
What did Polite do?
Yo, ask your question.
You remember me. I met you in New York.
Let's start with the first dynasty. First dynasty. Wait a minute. Stop. Let's start with the first dynasty. Have they found any bodies of the first dynasty? Yes or no? All right. No. Second dynasty. Have they found any pharaohs of the second dynasty?
No.
Okay. Third dynasty. Have they found any bodies of the third?
Show me one body. Show me Solomon's temple.
The body argument is a body fiat. The body argument is a body fiat. First, second, third. Dynasty 23.
That's an esoteric text with hidden science stolen from ancient Kemet.
You guys have no body. The body argument is a body fiat, dude, man. Please.
No, hold on. Where's Solomon? Or was that an esoteric text that was stolen from a principal ancient Kemet? Where is Solomon's temple at? Show me Solomon's temple.
Show me where it's in Kemet. So when you read the Bible, the only reason we fell in captivity or in slavery was because we broke God's laws, statutes, and commandments, man. God said do not commit adultery. And what do you blacks and Hispanics do? You promote adultery or sleeping with the next man's wife in your radio to impress the so-called white man so you can get some money out of it. What do we promote? Gang banging. Alright? Everybody's fighting for colors. Oh, I'm a blood, oh, I'm a crip, I'm a knight king, but ain't nobody ready to shoot these so-called white people that's playing as cops in the fucking hood, man. This is my language, man. This is real talk. None of you are uniting to come and shoot the cops in the hoods that's shooting you every day.
Right.
And guess what the Bible said? You blacks and Hispanics would be scared of the white man because he broke his laws and commandments. And that's the curse, man. If I ask 20 blacks and Hispanics right now to stand up and go against the police department, ain't none of y'all gonna do it because you fear it.
Right.
You're scared.
That's a fact.
And guess what? The master here ain't giving us a spin of fit up here, man. So right. We call a white man the devil to his face, even if we call him as a so-called policeman. Because guess what? The new KKK outfit is the police outfit.
Right.
In case you didn't know. Okay? The new KKK are the men in blue, man. The men in blue is supposed to be uniting against, man. Any so-called blacks and Hispanics that want to join the force or join the police department or support them, you don't have to tell them to sell to your own people, man. And God's not dealing with you.
Right.
Read that. Right, Isaiah chapter 5 verse 13, come on.
And their honorable men are famished.
Right, your honorable men are famished, man. You think Farrakhan is an honorable man, but guess what? He's teaching you nothing but lies, man. Did you know that Farrakhan came and said that blacks are the children of Israel in the newspapers? But he's still hanging around so-called fake Jews to camouflage the truth behind it because he's paid off a lot of you blacks and Hispanics. So guess what the white man does? He sends our own people to mix the lie with the truth, and now you're confused about who you are. Now you're confused about where you come from, what's your homeland. Because guess what? The white man tells us Africa is our homeland. Now how many blacks and Hispanics are sitting here, raise their hand, and validify or vouch for the fact that you come from Africa? How many?
Raise your hand.
None. You know why? Because the white man taught you that lie.
Right.
Let me get Galatians chapter 4, verse 26 real quick. Okay? The white man taught you, you come from Africa. But guess what? The Africans were the same ones that sold the Negroes into slavery. Okay? When you read the Bible, Africans and Negroes are not the same people. Why do you think when you come from Africa, they look at you different? They see you different. They don't even want to mingle with you in the hood. You know why? Because they know their roots. And they know they're not your people. Meanwhile, you so-called Negroes are so busy trying to cling on to a nation that's not yours, man. All right, so read that.
Galatians 4:26. But Jerusalem, which is above all, is free.
Right.
Which is the mother of us all.
Right, the Bible said Jerusalem is the mother of us all, man. It's not Africa like the white man taught you to believe. The white man is not ever the deceiver and a liar that the Bible speaks of, man. And guess what? When Christ comes back, the so-called black man, they're all born into slavery. Thus saith the Lord in the Bible. Okay? So Jerusalem is above and is free, which is